Welcome, everyone. The night of our dear Savior's birth, 2,000 years ago or so, we're so honored to have you in the sanctuary here at First English Lutheran. We welcome all visitors. We welcome anybody that's watching online. This is a glorious time in the history and the reality of Christianity. My name is intern Vicki Peterson-Jenks, and that's great. We're just honored to have you here this evening. I wanted to announce that Pastor Cheryl is ill with COVID, so we're sad about that, and if you happen to be watching right now, Pastor Cheryl, we love you, and we hope for a very rapid recovery. There will not, then, alas, be communion this evening. But we are honored nonetheless to now find silence as we gather here to worship. So if you would, please stand as your comfort level. We will listen to the bell first. Let's sing, O Come All Ye Faithful.
Oh, come,
the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. He was in the beginning with God. All things came into being through him, and without him, not one thing came into being. What has come into being in him was life, and the life was the light of all people. The light shines in the darkness, and the darkness did not overcome it. Jesus, the bright morning star, shines light in the world.
By day and night, he shines for all to see.
Jesus was born in the midst of injustice and poverty.
That the world may see the justice and richness of God.
God so loved the world that God sent Jesus.
So that all who believe in him may not perish, but have eternal life.
Jesus is the light of the world.
Jesus is the light of our lives.
Sing to God a new song.
A song of hope, joy, and peace around the world.
Grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And also with you.
Gracious God of heaven and earth, you have thrown a lifeline to us in our darkness, a beam of light that shines through Jesus, the born in a manger. He is the firstborn of all creation. Though crucified on a cross, he is the Lord of life. Fill us with wonder and joy of his presence in the world and in our hearts. Amen. Please be seated.
Our first reading today is from the book of Isaiah, chapter 9, verses 2 through 7.
The people who walked in darkness have seen a great light. Those who lived in a land of deep darkness, on them light was shined. You have multiplied the nation. You have increased its joy. They rejoice before you as with joy at the harvest, as people exult when dividing plunder. For the yoke of their burden and the bar across their shoulders, the rod of their oppressor, you have broken as on the day of Midian. For all the boots of the tramping warriors and all the garments rolled in blood shall be burned as fuel for the fire. For a child has been born for us, a son given to us. Authority rests upon his shoulders, and he is named Wonderful Counselor, Mighty God, Everlasting Father, Prince of Peace. His authority shall grow continually, and there shall be endless peace for the throne of David and his kingdom. He will establish and uphold it with justice and with righteousness from this time onward and forevermore. The zeal of the Lord of hosts will do this. Word of God, word of life. Our psalm today will be Psalm 96, and we will read responsively by verse. Sing to the Lord a new song. Sing to the Lord, all the earth. Declare God's glory among the nations and God's wonders among all peoples.
For great is the Lord, and greatly to be praised, more to be feared than all gods.
As for all the gods of the nations, they are but idols, but you, O Lord, have made the heavens. Ascribe to the Lord, you families of these peoples, ascribe to the Lord honor and power.
Ascribe to the Lord and honor to you with the holy name. Bring offerings and enter the courts of the Lord.
Worship the Lord in the beauties of holiness. Tremble before the Lord, all the earth. Let the heavens rejoice, and let the earth be glad. Let the sea thunder, and all that is in it. Let the field be joyful, and all that is therein.
Then shall all the trees of the forest shout for joy at your coming, O Lord. For you come to judge the earth.
You will judge the world with righteousness, and the peoples with your truth. Our second reading is from the book of Titus, chapter 2, verses 11 through 14. The grace of God has appeared, bringing salvation to all, training us to renounce impiety and worldly passions, and in the present age to live lives that are self-controlled, upright, and godly. While we wait for the blessed hope and the manifestation of the glory of our great God and Savior Jesus Christ, he it is who gave himself for us, that he might redeem us for all iniquity and purify for himself a people of his own, who are zealous for good deeds. Word of God, word of life.
Thanks be to God.
Please stand.
Thank you.
1 through 7. In those days, a decree went out from Emperor Augustus that all the world should be registered. This was the first registration and was taken while Quirinius was governor of Syria. All went to their own towns to be registered. To us is born a Savior.
Jesus Christ our Lord.
Joseph also went from the town of Nazareth in Galilee to Judea, to the city of David, called Bethlehem, because he was descended from the house and family of David. He went to be registered with Mary, to whom he was engaged, and who was expecting a child. To us is born a Savior.
Jesus Christ our Lord.
While they were there, the time came for her to deliver her child, and she gave birth to her firstborn son and wrapped him in bands of cloth and laid him in a manger because there was no place for them in the inn. To us is born a Savior.
Jesus Christ our Lord.
The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, O Christ.
Please be seated. Would the children please come to the front? We have chairs for you. All children and parents can come too. Don't be shy, it's Christmas Eve. There we go. Hi, Madeline. You can be sitting right there. Awesome, beautiful. Come on, come on. Yeah, yeah, come, come, come join us. I'm tall, but I don't bite. Want to have a seat there? Any others? Okay, well, we're going to do the children's sermon right now. This, by the way, is taken from Luke chapter 2, verses 8 through 20. And this is written by Pastor Cheryl, so it's as though she's with us this evening, because she is. Okay. While Mary and Joseph are in Bethlehem with baby Jesus, who's just been born, something amazing is happening out in the country, really, on the hillsides where the shepherds are taking care of their or sheep. Excellent. Audience involvement is very important. They're a little shy. We're not shy up here, though. Okay, look at the pictures of the shepherds. They see a star. Do you see that star? It's super bright, isn't it? Yeah. And they wonder, why is it shining so brightly on this night? Suddenly, an angel of the Lord is right there in front of them, and it is surrounded by brightness and magnificent light. And the shepherds are very, very afraid. This is the last thing they expected to see in the middle of the night out in the fields with their... Excellent. The angel sees how afraid they are, and it says to them, "Don't be afraid. I'm here to give you the best news you'll ever hear. It will make you happier than you've ever been. Today, a baby has been born who is your Savior. That means he will save you from your sin and forgive you all the wrong things that you've done. He has been born tonight in Bethlehem, the city of David. He's the Messiah for whom you've been waiting for such a long, long time. Now, this is how you'll know if you found him. He will be wrapped in bands of cloth, and he'll be lying in a manger." Suddenly, there is with the angel hundreds and hundreds of other angels. They light up the sky with their joy and their brightness, and they're singing loudly in the most beautiful voices, "Glory to God in the highest heaven, and on earth, peace and goodwill to all people." What a marvelous concert the shepherds hear. Well, eventually the angels disappear back into the sky, and the shepherds are still pretty excited. They decide they're going to go to Bethlehem and look for this baby that the angels have told them about. They say, "The Lord God has told us about this new baby, so we better get going." And so they go quickly. And they find Mary and Joseph, and they find baby Jesus too, just as the angels said they would. He's wrapped all snuggly, and he's lying in the manger while his parents watch him. The shepherds tell Mary and Joseph about those angels, and Mary and Joseph are pretty excited too. Later, the shepherds tell everyone about the angels and the new baby Jesus, and everyone says, "That's wonderful. That's amazing. Glory to God." The Bible says that Mary pondered it in her heart. That means she thought about it a lot. She wondered about it. She loved God and she thanked him for the beautiful new baby who would save the people and save you and me and all of us from our sins. And guess what the shepherds did? Well, they went back to their fields and their sheep, and they just kept saying, "God is wonderful. God is amazing. We're so glad that God has sent us Jesus to be our Savior. Alleluia. Amen." Children, you may return to your seats. Everyone, if you can grab your candle there and put it on, because now we'll segue into singing a beloved song we all know, Silent Night. If there's one Christmas carol that touches our hearts, it's Silent Night. Each year we revisit it, and each year it kindles within us a quiet awe that gently reminds us what Christmas is all about. It's a still point, isn't it? A time when we're once more amazed that God loved us enough to come to us. God's intent? C.S. Lewis states it succinctly. "The Son of God became the Son of Man so that the sons and daughters of men and women could become sons and daughters of God." Was the night silent when Jesus came? Probably not. Not with so many people in Bethlehem for the census. Just think of the noise of the animals alone. But we know that whenever God is present, there is a stillness, a quieting of the heart, a time to put anxiety to rest, and to realize that God is, after all, God. It is God's world, and God cares enough about this world and about us to take on human form, to be born of a virgin, and to grow up to sacrifice his very life for our sins. Does that create awe and wonder within you? It does for me. Let's sing the first verse of Silent Night together. Realm, another dimension called heaven. That realm is filled with joy and purity, light and peace, reality and honesty. There are no misleading commercials or biased newscasts. You don't have to weigh everything you hear to decide if it's true, because truth is everywhere and a part of everyone. God is there. God is there. And there is music and laughter and kindness and a profound sense of worship and gratitude, praise and honor. It is an expansive dimension with no end. But amazingly enough, this dimension we cannot even begin to visualize was not large enough to hold the joy of its residents when Christ was born on earth. Angels burst through the barrier between the worlds and appeared to the lowest caste of people, shepherds. Their visit was so unexpected that the shepherds were terrified. The angels had the courtesy to quell the shepherds' fear, but they could not quell their own joy. Alleluia! Christ has been born. Glory to God in the highest. Finally, finally, the human race would be put right with God. Go quickly, they urged the shepherds. Go worship the newborn king. And so they went. Wouldn't you go too, if the angels broke the good news to you? Our second verse. I wonder if the shepherds thought they were dreaming. At least it was a dream they could share. They'd seen and heard the angels together, and now they were hurrying through Bethlehem seeking out a baby in a manger. And then they were there. And just as the angels had said, a little family was huddling around the manger, trying to find some privacy in the crude surroundings. The mother was young and tired. She'd made a long trip just before giving birth. Only a woman who has experienced the last 2 days of a pregnancy can understand how difficult it must have been for Mary. The father hovered around the mother and child, ready to defend them against the intrusion of a bunch of shepherds. The shepherds, of course, meant no harm, and they bowed down and they worshiped the baby. And then their story bubbled out. The angels, the glory, the proclamation of the birth of Christ the Savior. And Jesus, the baby, swaddled in cloths and lying in a manger, did what human babies do. Were there radiant beams shining from his face? We don't know. But we do know that he was God's Son and that he was truly the dawn of redeeming grace. Our third verse.
Joseph, are you awake?
Mm-hmm.
It wasn't a dream after all. The baby is still here.
Well, I think he's going to be here for quite a while, Mary.
Well, yes, I know, but doesn't it seem almost impossible that all of this has really happened? I mean, from the very beginning, when the angel told me I would conceive a child without a human father, nothing has been normal. We've been living in a place between two worlds, carrying divine secrets within ourselves, yet understanding so little of the whole plan. We know the baby will save the people from their sins, but still, we don't understand how or why we were chosen to be part of this.
Do you remember how the angel also appeared to me and told me that the child within you was not of a human father, and that I should be unafraid to take you as my wife? I'm a well-reasoned man, Mary. I know that I did not make up that angel, but would others believe us if we told them the entire story?
Probably not. And now we have more to add to that story. Those shepherds last night.
Can you imagine a bunch of rough shepherds leaving their sheep in the fields and traveling into town so they could worship our baby?
I know. Wasn't that incredible? They said angels told them about Jesus' birth. It has to be true. How else could they have known about us?
What kind of plan are we part of, Mary? I know it's God's plan, but what will our lives be like from here on?
I don't know. This child, this beautiful, healthy child that has come from my body. What child is this, Joseph?
Well, remember when the angel told me we should call him Jesus because he would save the people from their sins?
Mm-hmm.
He is the Savior, Mary. He is the Messiah, the Son of God.
beautiful Savior is next. Stay seated. Please stand as you're able. With hope and expectation, we offer our prayers for the church and the world and all who await God's day of restoration. You promised mercy to Abraham and Sarah and their descendants forever. Bring your church into thoughtful, caring, and collaborative relationship with those of other faiths. Strengthen our shared values that we work together in caring for our world. Merciful God, receive our prayer. As fields and crops lie dormant, bless them with holy rest. Prepare them to thrive, that they provide abundant food in due season. Protect animals who hibernate and provide for all who scavenge for food in the lean season. Merciful God,
receive our prayer.
You raise up the lowly and cast down the arrogant. Teach humility to all in positions of authority. Break down systems of oppression, especially systems that perpetuate inequity and exclusion. Do not allow wealth, power, or pride to become idols that obscure your call to justice. Merciful God, look with favor upon all who cry out to you. Accompany with tenderness all who are afraid or ill, especially Pastor Cheryl, Lucy, Roger, and Don, Gary, Dan, Bill, Ryan, Walt, Micah, Gail and Jennifer, Anne and Mary. Rescue all who experience abuse or who live under the threat of violence, especially refugees, immigrants, in search of a safe and stable home. Merciful God, you are pleased to make your home among us. Make our homecomings now joyful as we gather with friends, families, and chosen families in celebration. Grant safety to all of us who travel. Merciful God, blessed are you for Mary and all the servants in every generation who lived according to your promise of mercy. Strengthen us by their example until the revelation of your glory is made known. Merciful God,
receive our prayer.
Listen to these and all our prayers, O God of hosts, and restore us with your great and everlasting mercy. Amen. Please share the peace. Let us pray. Good and loving God, we rejoice in the birth of Jesus, who came among the poor to bring the riches of your grace. As you have blessed us with your gifts, let them be blessings for others, with the trees of the field, with all heaven and earth. We shout for joy at the coming of your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. Thank you. Let's stand for the Lord's Prayer. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. Please be seated as we sing Away in a Manger and the First Noel.
Thank you.
Please stand. Praise God, from whom all blessings flow.
Praise God, all creatures here below.
You are the shepherds telling the story.
We tell it in the streets and across the land.
You are the wise ones, worshiping with thanksgiving.
We worship with gifts of song and service, talents and treasures.
You are the angels announcing peace.
We live with joy and go now in peace.
Almighty God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, bless you now and forever. Amen. Amen. Go with joy to tell the story. Christ the Savior is born. Glory to God in the highest. And on earth, peace, goodwill to all people. Blessed Christmas to all of you.